Weekend, the Earth is going to come into a very close pass to another celestial body. We're talking about the moon. The largest full moon of the year will grace our skies Saturday night. It will pass a mere 221,000 miles from Earth. Derek Pitts, the Franklin Institute Planetarium's chief astronomer, joins us now with an explainer. I always assumed that the moon's orbit was circular, but I guess it's a little bit oval, huh, Derek?
Yes, it is. It's oval, John, and because it's oval, what that means is that there are periods when the moon is closer to the Earth than others. It's called perigee, when it has this close pass, and then there's a more distant pass called apogee. So tomorrow night we have a convergence of the full moon and perigee.
I looked up the time when moonrise hits here on the East Coast, at least. It's around 7:46, 7:50. When it's coming up through the horizon, it's going to look just above the horizon, it's going to look really big, isn't it?
Yes, it will. And this is a very interesting optical illusion. We often think that the reason why the moon looks larger is because maybe the atmosphere is magnifying it somehow. And in this case, people are thinking that it looks bigger because it's a little bit closer to Earth. But it's actually this optical illusion of seeing the moon near objects of known size on the horizon that makes it appear larger. You can measure it and see that it isn't, though.
So it's really just the same size as it would be if it were in the noon position.
If you were to take a ruler, John, and measure the height of the moon or the size of the moon on the horizon, and then measure the moon again when it's almost directly overhead, you'd find out that it's exactly the same size.
There are some folks who are saying that we could be in for all kinds of problems, earthquakes and the like. Any truth to that?
Well, here's something to consider. You know, the moon is only going to be about 3% closer to the Earth, and the gravitational effect that that has may affect some tides, but only to the tune of about maybe an inch or so difference in height. So in reality, the pull of the moon is not going to have that great an effect on anything for volcanic eruptions or earthquakes or any of those sorts of things. I think it's going to be the connection between the supermoon effect and Cinco de Mayo that causes the most interesting effects.
Aha, so 3% larger, but 16% brighter, I understand. It's going to be really cool looking. Best place to see it?
The best place to see it is outside. Any place you can get that gives you a good view of the moon, preferably around the horizon at the time it rises, that'll be the greatest effect. But that actual effect coinciding of the two events is at 11:30 at night. You'll still be able to see the moon then, too.
I'll be out there howling. All right, Derek Pitts, thank you.